Okay, and take a deep breath for the next one. Franklin Roosevelt.
Well, yeah, we could be here all day. He did so much. One thing he did, of course, was stay in office for more than two terms. That was not unconstitutional, but it violated a long-standing precedent which had been set by Washington, of all people. And a lot of people did accuse him of being a dictator, not just for that, but because, of course, in the New Deal, he vastly expanded the power of the federal bureaucracy, and he got Congress to pass laws which were what lawyers call delegations of power. Basically, rather than passing a law that says, you know, you have to do this or that to ordinary people, the laws say to the president, you figure out what people should do. So to use an anachronistic example, but an easy one to understand, when environmental law was eventually enacted in the 1970s, Congress didn't really say, you know, here are all the pollutants and this is what you should do about them. Congress said to the executive branch, do something about air pollution and do something about water pollution. And the Supreme Court initially struck down these laws, but eventually acquiesced in them. And then it was up to the bureaucracy and the executive branch, ultimately the EPA, to figure out what the rules were. And then the final thing, of course, is World War II. And of course, you know, for all intents and purposes, during the war, Roosevelt was a dictator who basically decided how things would go, both in terms of how the war was prosecuted and in terms of domestic policy.
But again, in extreme times, we give more leeway, yes?
We do, but what's striking here is that in both settings, things, you know, were permanently changed. So once the administrative state was put in place and strengthened under Roosevelt, it just remained there and ever since has become more and more powerful. There was a very brief and weak effort to roll it back in the mid to late 40s. And then, you know, from time to time, people like Ronald Reagan say, you know, we should deregulate. But basically, this system of administrative governance is fully entrenched. And then on the foreign policy side, the president basically is the commander-in-chief and as leader of foreign policy, his decisions just had much more importance than they had before World War II, and that would never change. That would become permanent.